What's up guys, welcome back to TenorShare channel. Apple just released the iOS 15 beta 2 today. And without exception I have just updated my devices to this latest version. If you still don't know how to install iOS 15 beta on your phone, check out this video. And guess what, I just found out the new feature that Apple has announced but just came out in this beta 2. It's called SharePlay. It would be turned on defaultly once you update it to beta 2. So in following video I will show you how SharePlay works on iOS 15. Let's jump in. So first thing first, you have to know what is SharePlay. Apple is now focusing on people's connections. That is, more important during this period. So they add one new feature to FaceTime. Letting people share what they're watching, listening, and even their home screen. So here as you can see, I'm having FaceTime chat with myself, please don't mind. But on two iPhone running on iOS 15 beta 2. Let's get closer to see how to use SharePlay on FaceTime. So on the right side menu bar, there is a share screen icon. And you can tap on it during your FaceTime call. Then share my screen. And there is a countdown before sharing. And it also reminds you that you can turn on Do Not Disturb to hide notifications. Okay, here we go. Let's go back to home screen. And boom. On the other side, you can clearly see the home screen we're sharing. Drag it. And it can even zoom to full screen. So there he is. And Apple also says we can share Apple Music through SharePlay. Let's check it out. So as you can see there's a pop-up saying SharePlay Music. It's working now. Just imagine you want to share your friend the song you're listening. Next time you can just say hey, let's SharePlay. And it's all done. Pretty cool. But during testing, I also found out some issue. Or maybe common problems you may meet. So please be noted. The first thing is that if you're in a weak network connection, it's quite buggy for you to use SharePlay. Just like this. I guess it may also have something to do with the beta version. And also, when you are sharing your screen, it's easy to find out that the sharing screen is quite laggy. So far we can't expect too much on this. But it's still a wow feature in the future I guess. So if you want to upgrade to iOS 15 to experience this new feature, just go ahead. But make sure you have backed up your iPhone before updating. Because once you decide to downgrade to iOS 14, all the data will be lost. You can consider using iCareFone to back up all your iPhone data to your computer if you're having problem using iTunes. And the backup feature is totally free. So you can go to tenorshare.com to get it on your computer. Okay, so that's all for today's video. If it helps, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. I'll be very grateful if you subscribe. Peace.